Hello, this is Solar PVTV once again from the sun in Munich, from InterSolar Europe 2017. And now we are together with Eitan Parnass, who came here from Israel, and he's representing the whole clean tech industry in the country. But also, Eitan is a secretary of the Global Solar Council. So first question, Eitan, why did you come actually? What brings you here to Munich?
I've been coming here to Munich actually for more than 7 years now, as many others, to try to see how we can change the world of energy, not less than that. The mission is quite clear: how to develop markets, how to share information, share best practices. It's actually to help this industry to grow.
Mm-hmm. And let's say that you are helping to grow the industry, I think, since 10 years, more or less, in Israel. So how would you describe, you know, this evolution of the industry, and what, in your opinion, will be the next steps in the country?
Okay, Israel, first of all, in Israel we have a good heritage for solar energy. We were actually implemented compulsory solar heaters, water heaters, and most of the rooftops of Israel are already covered with solar heaters, and we are using solar power for more than 30 years now. So in Israel, when PV was introduced in 2008, it was quite expensive. We are a very conservative economy, and the treasury is highly controlling the economy. This, I would say, have made solar introduction quite slow in terms of actually installed capacity. Now, what have changed throughout the years is that the treasury is actually looking at solar now economically feasible. It's the price of producing a kilowatt hour now in 2017 is less than the production of fossil price. So we are going to see really what we are experiencing today is actually a U-turn. The government is now very keen about solar. They are doing their first steps, and they are very serious about solar energy, photovoltaic now in Israel. So we are now facing a new era of regulation. First of all, from 2017, it is very easy for every rooftop residential to actually implement and construct a solar rooftop. In the past, there were taxation issues and others, and now it's solved. And also, we have introduced for the first time auctioning mechanism, and the first cap is 1 gigawatt. Mm-hmm. Out of total 5 to 7 gigawatt, we will need it 2013. So the government has actually implemented the governmental plan. We issued, of course, the goals. We have goals for renewables at large that were actually as part of the COP21 obligation that we are fulfilling. And now we are taking the first steps to actually have solar massively implemented in Israel in the next years to come.
And Israel is a country which is really pushing for the innovation. It's one of the most innovative countries in the world. So I believe that within the government you have a lot of discussions about transition of the country towards the clean technologies and also towards the electric cars. So how do you see the place of solar industry within this transition?
Okay, so you are right, of course, Tomas. Israel is always pro-innovation, and a lot of new ideas are coming from Israel laboratories, but I can tell you that it is very tough. It's not an easy place for scientists. The government makes it tough, and only the toughest survive. And we have the toughest innovation survive. We've got good ideas coming alive. We do see now actually the laboratories and also new scientists are dealing with new materials, nanotechnology, and it really looks promising. What we do need in this industry at large, and this is not just Israel, but looking at the industry at large, what we do need is more investment on the side of the industry in innovation. Because the implementation might take a few years, sometimes it's buzz, new technology to get into the market. I know that some of the module manufacturers, they would seek a technology that will be fruitful in 2 years, but what we have today, new materials in the laboratory, might take 5 years. So a lot of the technologies do not survive, and I see it as a personal mission to actually help those technologies come alive, to prosper, and of course to transform the world of energy, and it will happen with new material probably and new technologies.
So you are one of the best friends of Pranav. Yes, from India. And Pranav is a man with the 3 heads, yes? And you are a man with 2 heads. So you are also a very involved, one of the most active guys within the Global Solar Council. And I would like to ask you, Eitan, so what is now the situation with the Global Council? Because you are following up very closely. And what is the role of Israel also within the Council?
Okay, so first of all, the Global Solar Council, it was launched as a big mission of actually introducing the global solar voice, the voice of this industry, to be represented at the junction where decisions are taken globally. UN and others, and the REAI and other places where other industries from renewables are presented. And we have a very nice work plan for 2017 and 18. In 2018, we will have a new chairman from GCL, and we are talking really now about strengthening our activities. After the first year, 1.5 years, we were busy actually establishing the links that we need to link to all the organization. We are now represented at IRENA. We are represented at other important junctions. And now we are going to embark on working plan to be launched. And we have got a lot of good ideas how to strengthen solar globally. Now, the role of Israel, as I see it, we are the secretary of the Global Solar Council. And we pushed really for innovation and technology. And we have launched last year, we have launched in Israel, the Global Solar Council Innovation Forum, together with IRENA. And this is a platform where we would like to see, as I told you, how funds can be directed to science, because this is, I think, the most important role. We would need the new solar technologies. We would need new generation of solar to success. It's not an easy task. We see how fossil drop throughout the world. We see how artificially the world of fossil is moving, and we need technology, because only technology would be able to outwin the shifting fossil logic, you might say, or illogic. It depends where you stand. And we need innovation and technology. So this is the role of Israel, my role at the Global Solar Council, as I see it.
And you are a big networker, yes? And I believe that you think that human relationship is so important, yes, within this industry. And how does it work in the country?
Okay, first of all, it is, of course, human, and your role as a media is, of course, important. But in the end of the day, I would say, when you talk about innovation, it is very important that new scientists, new innovators will actually know about this industry, what is happening in this industry. And there is a great importance that both media and also human relations can, this is how the knowledge is transferred. When there will be demand from the industry, new science will evolve. And of course, we will need funds for this. It's not funded enough globally, and we would like to see really what has happened in the COP21, talking about billions of budgets that will go to clean technology. We would like to see now how it actually happens, and how we will allow the new generation of scientists the fund needed to actually flourish new ideas.
So the last question, Eitan, just when speaking about the numbers, so how do you see this year installations in Israel, and what is your forecast for the year 2018?
Okay, so first of all, for the past years, we had very minimal tens of megawatts installed each year. This year we are launching, the tender were launched, the first cap was 235 megawatts, and it will be installed in 21 months from now. We are going to see another cap of around the same quantity being launched this August. And we are talking about transmissions, large-scale plants. And in October, we are going to launch an extra cap. And altogether, they should be accumulated to around a gigawatt of caps. Aside those auctioning mechanisms, we have a very good net metering scheme that will allow one really very good return on investment. And we have already 100 megawatts installed of net metering. And we would probably see this net metering even growing even better. And this is how we would like to see it, allowing the people to generate electricity, also connecting to the grid. As I told you, Israel is keen about going solar, and we have got really a good financial situation in Israel. The economy is ranked A+, so the banks will allow you the finance need, and actually they will queue in line to allow you financing. So the sun is shining, and the money is in the bank, and the technology is okay. So now we just have to perform.
So it means that you are inviting the international viewers, international industry, to come to Israel, yes?
Yes, but do come one at a time, because we're a very small country. We would like to have you as guests.
Okay, thank you so much. That was Solar PV TV together with Eitan, who is the boss, let's say, of the solar and clean tech industry in Israel, and also working very hard for the Global Solar Council. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.